creating the boot image. In previous video, we explained how to create a Hello World project in Vitis. Today, we are going to use the same project. After building the project and generating the YLF file, right-click on the project and select Create Boot Image. In the dialog box, specify the output directory and the desired image name, then click Create Boot Image. This process will package the following three components into a bootable image. First stage bootloader, FSBL, initializes the hardware and prepares the system for further boot stages. PL Bitstream configures the FPGA programmable logic. Executable YLF file. This is the application that runs on the ARM core. For convenience, you can copy the output directory path, or I'll guide you to the location where the boot image is saved. Once the process is complete, you'll see a confirmation message indicating that the boot image has been successfully generated. The boot image will be located in the boot image folder within the IDE directory. To quickly access it, right-click on the generated boot image and select Properties, and then press Show in System Explorer. It allows you to easily locate the file. Program the QSPI from Vitis IDE. Please note that when programming the QSPI, it is recommended to set the board to JTAG boot mode. Ensure the board is connected to your computer via a JTAG cable. Once the board is properly connected, right-click on the project and select Program Flash. For the image file, select the boot.bin file you just created. If it is not automatically selected, you can browse to the correct directory to locate it. The offset field specifies the memory location where boot file will be programmed. For QSPI Flash, this is commonly set to 0, which programs the image at the start of the flash memory. The flash type refers to the specific QSPI chipset used on your carrier board. You can find this information in the board schematic or check your Vivado project settings. The flash type selected in Vivado must match the hardware configuration. For example, on the ZCU104 board, the flash type is typically single X for QSPI. The initial file should be the first stage bootloader, FSBL, generated during your project setup. If it is not automatically selected, locate it in the boot folder within your project's platform directory. I can show you quickly where this FSBL is located. You can find it in Hardware Platform under Export Directory. Now, let's go and continue programming the QSPI. Finally, you can enable additional verify options such as blank check and verify to ensure successful flashing. Once everything is configured, click the program button to start programming the QSPI flash. As you can see, the programming process will first erase the QSPI flash and then write the image to it chunk by chunk. After writing each chunk, the offset is automatically incremented to prepare for the next chunk. If everything goes smoothly, you should see a flash operation successful message at the end of the process. Programming QSPI from Vivado. In Vivado, open the hardware manager and connect to the device. Right-click on the device and select Add Configuration Memory Device. This allows you to specify the QSPI type and add it to the hardware manager. If you know the exact chipset installed on your board, you can simply type its name to quickly find it in the list. Otherwise, you'll need to go through the filters one by one and manually select the correct QSPI chip from the available options. Next, the QSPI device should appear in the Hardware Manager. Right-click on it and select Program Configuration Memory Device. Configuration file. The configuration file is the FPGA's bitstream or a boot image to be programmed into the flash memory, usually is a MCS or bin file. You can browse to the desired file using the triple dot button and select the boot image that we created. Bin offset. This field defines the starting address offset in the flash memory for programming the configuration file. An offset of 0 typically indicates programming from the beginning of the QSPI flash. For Zynq FSBL, we again select the same FSBL from the Vitis project. Program operations. This section allows you to customize the programming process. Address range has two different options. Configuration file only. It ensures only the portion corresponding to the provided file will be erased and programmed. Entire configuration option. it will erase the whole QSPI flash memory. When erase checked, it ensures the relevant flash memory sections are erased before programming. Program, when is checked, will program the configuration file to the flash memory. If it is not checked, it will only erase the QSPI. Verify option verifies the correctness of the data after it has been programmed into the flash memory. Checking this option will cause the Vivado to take more time. Now, press the OK button and flashing process will start. As you can see, the Vivado starts to erase the QSPI first. Then it programs the QSPI with the selected boot image. And at the end, it will check and verifies the written data. If everything goes smoothly, you should see a flash operation successful message at the end of the process. Set the boot mode dip switches. First, configure the FPGA evaluation board to boot from QSPI. On the ZCU104, locate the boot mode switches and set them as follows. Open the serial terminal to see the output. To open the serial terminal and view the output, connect a USB UART cable from the board to your PC. Then, use a terminal program such as Tera Term. Set the baud rate to 115,200 with 8 data bits, 1 stop bit, and no parity. If you don't have Tera Term installed, you can also use the Vitis terminal. In that case, open a new terminal in Vitis and configure the serial port settings accordingly. Power recycle the board. Reboot the board by powering recycle the board. Once the device is booted, we can see that the LED starts to blink. It means that the PL side is programmed properly. You should see the Hello World message appear in the Vitis serial terminal or your external terminal program. Write the boot image to the SD card and boot from it. We have already created the boot image, and now we can write it to the SD card. To confirm that the board is booting from the SD card, I generated a second boot image that outputs Hello World from SD card to the console. To make the SD card ready, insert the SD card into your PC and format it using the FAT32 file system. Once the formatting is complete, copy the boot image onto the SD card. After that, remove the SD card from the PC and insert it into the board. Next, configure the boot mode dip switches. This time, adjust the switches as shown in the displayed figure. It ensures that the board will boot from the SD card. Reboot the board by powering recycle the board. The device will boot from SD card. Again, we can see that the LED starts to blink and expected message appears in the serial terminal.